प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन नंबर 4, पंकज लिमिटेड मैन्युफैक्चर एंड सोल्ड 2000 कंप्यूटर्स इन द ईयर एंडिंग 31 मार्च 2017। पंकज लिमिटेड वर्ष 31 मार्च 2017 ना वर्ष दरमियान 2000 कंप्यूटर बनावे छे अने वेचे छे। द समराइज्ड ट्रेडिंग अकाउंट एंड प्रॉफिट लॉस अकाउंट इज गिवन बिलो। नफा नुकसान खातु अने व्यापार खाता नी माहिती नीचे प्रमाणे छे, तमे जोई शको छो नीचे प्रॉफिट लॉस एंड ट्रेडिंग बन्ने आपेला छे। फॉर द ईयर एंडिंग 31 मार्च 2018 इट इज एस्टिमेटेड दैट 31 मार्च 2018 ना अंते जे वर्ष पूरु थवा जई रह्यु छे एमां एवुं नक्की एवो अंदाज छे। नंबर 1, आउटपुट एंड सेल्स विल बी 4000 कॉम्प्यूटर्स, 4000 कॉम्प्यूटर बनावामां आवशे अने वेचवामां आवशे। Price of materials will rise by 20% on the previous year's level. ગયા વર્ષે જે માલ સામાનની કિંમત હતી એમાં અંદાજિત 20% વધારો થશે। Wages will rise by 5%, મજૂરીમાં 5% અંદાજ વધારો થશે। નંબર 4, મેન્યુફેક્ચરિંગ કોસ્ટ વિલ રાઇઝ બાય 10%, ઉત્પાદન પડતર ઉત્પાદન ખર્ચમાં અંદાજિત 10% વધારો થશે। નંબર 5, સેલિંગ એક્સપેન્સ પર યુનિટ વિલ રિમેન અનચેન્જ। Be remember, selling expense per unit will remain unchanged. વેચાણ ખર્ચ એકમ દીઠ ફેરબદલ નહીં થાય, એટલે પર યુનિટમાં કોન્સ્ટન્ટ આવશે। નંબર 6, અધર એક્સપેન્સ વિલ રિમેન અનઅફેક્ટેડ બાય ધ રાઇઝ ઇન આઉટપુટ। આ સિવાયના જે ખર્ચાઓ છે એમાં ઉત્પાદનમાં ફેરફાર થવાથી કોઈ ચેન્જીસ થશે નહીં। યુ આર રિક્વાયર્ડ ટુ સબમિટ અ સ્ટેટમેન્ટ ફોર ધ બોર્ડ ઓફ ડિરેક્ટર્સ શોઈંગ ધ પ્રાઇઝ એટ વિચ કોમ્પ્યુટર વુડ બી માર્ક so as to show a profit of 20% on selling price. આપણે સ્ટેટમેન્ટ બનાવવાનું છે વેચાણ કિંમત ઉપર 20% નફો મેળવવો હોય ત્યારનું। આનો આન્સર ચેક કરીએ, ફર્સ્ટ વન, કોસ્ટ શીટ ઓફ પંકજ લિમિટેડ ફોર ધ યર એન્ડિંગ 31 માર્ચ 2017, ઇન વિચ there is manufacturing units 2000 and sales unit also 2000. As per table, first one, there is cost of material. It is given in trading account, there is 120,000. So here it is 120,000 divided by 2000 manufacturing units. So it will be rupees 60 per unit. Then direct wages also given in trading account, it is rupees 180,000. So 180,000 divided by 2000 manufacturing units, so it is rupees 90 rupees per unit. So we get prime cost rupees 150 per unit and total rupees 3 lakh. Then we have to add factory overheads into prime cost. There is a manufacturing overheads which is also given in trading account, which is rupees 75,000. So per unit it is rupees 37.5. 75,000 divided by 2000. Now manufacturing overhead should be added into prime cost, then we get factory cost or a works cost rupees 187.5 in unit wise, while it is rupees 3,75,000 in total amount. Then we have to added office overheads. Now we check our profit and loss account statement. There is a staff salary, rent, taxes, selling expense, general expense and net profit. So there is staff salary, rent and rates and general expense. These are the office expenses. So first one, staff salary rupees 90,000. Rent and rates rupees 15,000 and general expense rupees 30,000. So total offers office overhead rupees 135,000 and unit wise 135,000 divided by 2000 manufacturing units, so it is rupees 67.5 in unit wise. Now this office overhead expense added into factory cost and we get total rupees 5,10,000 in unit wise rupees 255. So cost of production or office cost rupees 255. Then we have to added opening stock of finished goods and a class closing stock of finished goods. But there is no any opening stock or finished goods because as per we read in question, there is 2000 computers manufactured and sold in 2017. It means there is no closing stock and there is no any information about opening stock. So there is dash dash. So production cost of goods sold is rupees 255 and in total rupees 5,10,000. Now we have to add sales and distribution expense. As per we read or seen in our profit loss account, there is only single expense, selling expense. It is rupees 45,000 in total amount. We remember sales and distribution expense divided by sales unit. If you want to calculate per unit, then it is divided by sales unit. But in this question, there is manufacturing units is 2000. Same way, sales unit are also 2000. So selling expense rupees 45,000 divided by 2000, it is rupees 22.5. Now this selling expense we have to add it into cost of goods sold, then total cost rupees 5,55,000 and in per unit rupees 277.5. There is net profit is given. So net profit is rupees 45,000, unit wise rupees 22.5. So we get sales rupees 6 lakh, 5,55,000 add 45,000. You have to remember this point while you calculating or preparing estimated sheet or tender sheet. There is a 2 point which you have to keep in your mind while you preparing a cost sheet or a tender sheet. First one, if there is increase or decrease in variable nature expenses, it should be calculated on per unit amount always. ચલિત ખર્ચમાં જો કંઈ વધારા ઘટાડાની સૂચના હોય તો એ હંમેશા એકમ દીઠ રકમ ઉપર ગણવો જોઈએ. સેમ વે દેર ઇઝ ઇન્ક્રીઝ ઓર ડિક્રીઝ ઇન ફિક્સ્ડ નેચર એક્સપેન્સીસ, ધેન ઇટ શુડ બી કેલ્ક્યુલેટેડ ઓન ટોટલ એમાઉન્ટ. સ્થિર ખર્ચમાં જો કંઈ વધારો કે ઘટાડાની સૂચના હોય તો એ હંમેશા કુલ રકમ પર ગણવો જોઈએ. આ બંને પોઈન્ટ્સ યુ તમારે યાદ રાખવાના રહેશે. યુ હેવ ટુ કીપ ઇન યોર માઇન્ડ always because you have to check question for preparing estimated sheet or cost sheet. Estimated sheet or a tender sheet. Here we have to prepare a estimated sheet for 2018. As per data given in question, in 2018 our estimate is manufacturing of 4000 computers and also sells 4000 computers. Now we prepare estimated sheet. First one, cost of material. In previous year, it is rupees 60 per unit. Here, information given there is chances or there is assumption the price will be rise by 20% of material. Material and wages is always variable nature expense because they are increased with level of production. And same way, they are decreased with level of production. So it is always considered as a variable nature expense. So as per we seen just before, there is a point, if there is increase or decrease in variable nature expense, then it should be calculated on per unit. Here material is a variable nature expense. So we have to calculate in unit wise data. There is cost of material rupees 60 in previous year. Now it is increased by 20%. So as per we calculate in bracket 60 rupees per plus 20%. So it will be 12 rupees per unit. So 60 plus 12, there is 72 rupees per unit. Now we have to calculate total. There is 72 rupees per unit into 4,000 manufacturing units. So 72,000, 72 into 4 is equal to 2,88,000. It will be cost of material. Same way, now direct wages, which is rupees 90 per unit in previous year 2017. But there is an estimation, it will be increased or it will be rise by 5%. We remember direct wages or direct labor is also a variable nature expense. So it should be calculated on per unit. So there is 90 rupees, it is a previous amount, then plus 5% estimated rise. So 90 plus 5%, it will be rupees 94.5 per unit. Now in total it is, it will be 94.5 into 4,000 is equal to 3,78,000. So there is a prime cost for 2018 is rupees 6,66,000 and unit wise it will be 166.5. Factory overheads. In factory overheads head, there is a only one expense, it is manufacturing overheads, which is in previous, it will be rupees 37.5 per unit. Manufacturing expense is also a variable nature because it is high or rise with level of production, and same way it is fall with level of production. There is a information given in our question, there is manufacturing cost will rise by 10%. So here we calculate like this, 37.5, it is a previous data per unit, and plus 10% of it. So it will be rupees 41.25 in unit wise column, then multiply 4,000 manufacturing units. So it will be rupees 165 in total amount. So total factory cost is rupees 831,000, and in unit wise it will be rupees 207.75. Now add office overheads. As per question data given in point number 6, other expense will remain unaffected by rise of output. By rise in output, there is a information about rise or decrease for material, wages, manufacturing expense and sales expense only. It means office overhead, there is no information about office overhead, so it will be remain unchanged. But we remember office overheads are a fixed nature expense, so they are remain in total amount for 2018. So staff salary will be remain rupees 90,000 in total amount as previous data. Same way rent rupees 15,000 and general expense rupees 30,000. So they are remaining total amount remain unchanged in total amount rupees 1,35,000. So now 1,35,000 divided by 4,000, then it will be rupees 33.75 in unit wise. Now office overhead should be added into factory cost, then we get cost of production or office cost rupees 241.5, and in total amount it is rupees, it will be rupees 9,66,000. Now we have to add opening stock of finished goods, then less closing stock of finished goods. But there is no opening stock or there is no closing stock because in 2017 we manufacture and sells 2000 computers. Same way in 2018 there is estimation for manufacture of 4000 computers and sell also 4000 computers. It means there is no opening stock or no closing stock for 2018. So cost of goods sold remain unchanged or equal to office cost 241.5 in unit wise and 9,66,000 in total amount. Now finally we have to add sales and distribution expense. There is sales and distribution expense in 2017, it is rupees 45,000, while in unit wise it was rupees 22.5. As per data given in question, information given in question, selling expense remained unchanged in unit wise. Selling expense data or selling expense remain unchanged in unit wise. So there is unit wise rupees 22.5 multiply now 4,000 units. Here in 2018 we will manufacture 4,000 units and we will sold same 4,000 units. We remember selling and distribution expense always affecting with sales unit. Here sales unit is 4,000. So 22.5 into 4,000. So we get total rupees 90,000 as a selling expense. Same added into cost of goods sold. Then we get total rupees 10,56,000. And in unit wise 264, which is considered as a total cost. Now, we have to add a profit or we apply a sales. There is a data given in last paragraph in question. Company wants 20% profit on sales price. We remember company wants 20% profit, but on sales price. There is no sales price is given. Here we complete up to this level. It means we have at right now there is total cost only 10,56,000. There is no information about profit, no data given about sales, but there is a single one hint. Company wants 20% profit on selling price. So it will be 25% on cost. So there is 10,56,000 multiplied 25%. So we get total rupees 2,64,000 as a profit, then divided 2,64,000 divided by 4,000 sales unit, then it will be rupees 66 per unit. Now cost plus profit is equal to sales 3,30,330, and in total amount or a total sales rupees 13,20,000.